Viewer discretion is advised. Amplifiers produced by Soundman Enterprises, Inc., Mobile Solutions, and CT Sounds. Go to soundmanca.com for iPad dash kits. Get the best car audio tools and training at mobilesolutions-usa.com and take a look at some innovative car audio equipment at ct-sounds.com. To me, getting all this little stuff figured out in order is the hard part. There's so many little fittings and odds and ends that I need to get everything working, but I don't necessarily know what they are at the time. You know, I just have to get a part and then figure out what I need to put it in. Today I gotta figure out some of this little shit. I need to plan out what fuel fittings I need and what kind of fuel line and all that shit. It's taken me like 2 hours to figure out and draw out all the fittings and how I'm gonna hook this up, because I have to know where I'm gonna put each unit so I know what type of fitting to order and what type of line to order. It's a mess and it's taking a long time. I'm getting frustrated. I place an online order and the people call me. Why would I want to talk on the phone if I'm making an order online? If I'm making an order online, it means I don't want to talk on the phone.
Of customer care. All of our representatives are currently busy. Please hold, and your call will be transferred to our next available rep.
That's not online. That's a phone order.
Thank you for holding. A representative will answer your call in the order it was received.
We live stream from the shop 24/7, soundmanca.com/live. I got a chat wall. You can always see it in the background. I can't go reading off credit card numbers here, people. I can't go reading off personal information. This isn't a conducive environment for phone calls. If I liked phone calls, I wouldn't be hanging out with Rafa's mom so much. The bitch speaks Spanish. We can't understand each other. Are we going to talk on the phone?
What do you say, B?
Thank you for calling Trix. This is Dana. How may I help you?
Yeah, I placed an order online because I can't talk on the phone, and I guess there's a problem, so now I gotta call you to complete the order. So now there's just a camera in my face while I talk on the phone. Because the reason I make online orders is because we're filming all day.
Okay, so you now, have an order number or phone number?
No. And now I gotta fucking call my Amex and see why it didn't go through, and then fucking call Jegs back. If I wanted to make goddamn phone calls all day, I would have ordered the shit over the phone. So then I called Amex. I don't even know what the fuck that guy said. He just kept going. Sounded like a fucking Chinese robot with an Indian accent. And then he wanted me to take a survey. The only question on your survey I'm going to answer is, where are you going to put that dick? And the answer's going to be right in your face, bitch. You're just with your surveys. I have a survey. What do you think of everything? It sucks. Everything sucks. Let's fucking fly. I was able to successfully place my order and get my fuel fittings and lines on the way. It would have been faster to steal them off the cars in the parking lot out here. You go to order parts, your bank holds the funds because they're like, oh, we thought it was fraud because you used your card. So you gotta call them, they release it, the order goes through, and then now I racked up AT&T overages because I was on the phone. So now that goes, gets charged to my account, overdrawing my checking account. go to place the next order, doesn't go through. I call overdraft fees. AT&T overages. Hopefully we have everything for the fuel system on its way so we can finish the fuel system. I'm already pissed. We're also gonna have to figure out the air ride system and finish that off. I got some of those fittings, but I don't have nearly enough. So I'm gonna have to place an online order and then have them call me and talk on the phone. If only I could reach to the phone and stuff cash up their fucking ass. Let me just read off my credit card here. I'll let you guys order the parts for me. See how the bank likes that shit. I've always heard of people using their AC compressor to fill up their air tank, but I've never actually seen it in person. I'd love to be able to use this factory Subaru air compressor to fill up my air tank. I was doing some research online. It looks like you can get a lot of PSI out of these. A lot of people use a York 210 compressor, which is pretty expensive, but it's a belt-driven compressor. The thing I'm not sure about the Subaru compressor is how to lubricate it, because it seems like there's some sort of lubrication in the air circulation line somehow. So I don't know if you'd need some kind of like water trap to separate out oil and then recirculate it back into the system with a little fuel injector. But it would be so sweet to be able to use this factory Subaru compressor to fill up the air tank. We could have the pressure switch on the air tank activate the clutch, so when the pressure drops below whatever PSI it's designated to, probably 125 or some shit, it'll kick the clutch on, fill up the tank, bam! I don't know if that's possible. It's getting worse. It's just getting more complicated. I gotta get something done this week. I'm gonna make a goal of trying to at least get my radiator tabs built. Right now, I'm gonna tack on the lower radiator tabs. Gotcha. Lower tabs turned out sweet. The radiator sets right onto the tabs. Tomorrow I'm going to try to make the upper ones. Come back tomorrow for a new episode of Amplified. The weekend is almost here. Make sure you go over to soundmanca.com, check out my new universal iPad mini kit, and you could also get Soundman shirts and the new sticker pack. You could hit me up on Twitter @DougBernards. I'll see you guys tomorrow.